Hello, my name is Amy Sturkey. I'm a pediatric physical therapist, and I am doing a couple of videos on how I think about behavior as it relates to my clients on the autistic spectrum. And the last two videos, I talked about the functions of behavior. And then I had just a couple other thoughts about behavior and how I work with children that did not follow easily into that context. First thing I'd want to say is that yelling and fussing rarely changes behaviors. The research indicates that really positive reinforcement and praise helps change behaviors better than saying negative things or giving punishment. So I try to find out what my clients like and try to do things that they enjoy in my session, so that I have a better chance of them learning. The research also says that if you're having fun, it's easier to learn. The next thing I do is I make sure I give very specific compliments. So, not good job, but I love the way you're throwing that ball, or you're doing so fantastic sitting in your seat, or I love the way you're walking right beside me. If you give very specific compliments, at first it feels a little awkward, but you'll get used to it. That means more than just, great, super, love that, for kids. It helps them understand exactly what they're doing that is the right thing. The next one is really important too. It's give the rewards immediately. Don't wait a couple of minutes after they've done something well to tell them how good they did or give them the reward. By then it's long past due. They have no idea what you're talking about. But if you give that reward as soon as they do that right thing, that you have it ready to go, you're going to be a much more powerful reward than if it waits several minutes when they might not connect the two things. Okay, the next thing is, remember, the firsts are often the worsts. So the first time you do an activity, the first session you are with a client, those firsts are often the worst. Because you might have a clue what you're doing, but your client or your child doesn't have a clue what they're doing. And so they don't know what to expect. And it's likely they're going to give you what I call change back behaviors. So if you're trying a new activity, they've never seen it before, or it's your first session with them, they're going to go, what? I don't like this new thing. Let's see if I can change your mind. If I act up wild enough, just maybe you'll stop doing this new thing, or I'll stop having to see you. Wouldn't that be cool? So you have to persevere through that first part just to be able to keep going so that your child can be successful later. That's what I call change back behaviors. And if you can look at it in that context, it makes it go a lot easier in the future for you because you know that better is yet to come. Another really good idea is to try to stay calm. So a lot of times how we act affects how they act. So if they are acting wild and we get upset, then that can make them get even more dysregulated and unhappy. So it's really important that if they're upset, that we stay calm. As human beings, when we look at another person who's upset, then we're more likely to get upset too. If we see somebody who's calm, we're more likely to be calm. So you want to be a calming influence on your clients, not an influence that makes them more dysregulated. So when they get upset, stay calm. I know some people that in their trainings, they wear a heart monitor. And so when their child gets upset, they have to check their heart rate to see if their heart rate is going up as well. And their goal is for their heart rate to unchanged when their child gets upset. The next one is that often I have parents in the room too, and we're working together with my child. As a parent, you might have another parent who are there, your partner or a sister or a brother or somebody else who's helping you work with a child. I think it's really important that when something goes awry, that one of y'all take commands. I just think about when I am trying to figure something out and I'm having a hard time. If I have multiple people giving me instructions and directions and telling me what to do, it can get overwhelming really fast. So I really try, if something's going on, and a parent starts taking care of the situation, that I don't also step in and try to help take care of it at the same time. I let one of us take the lead and one of us steps back. And I think that makes a big difference in the organization of my client and how quickly they recover from difficulties. The next one is, it's really important to look at the situation from the child's perspective. And again, it's so important that you think about what percentage of the ratio of what you say good versus bad is to your child. So I fear that a lot of times our children on the spectrum, they can be tricky. So it's quite possible that a lot of the input they get is don't do this, don't do that, stop this, stop that, and not a lot of positives. So I really go for a 80% positive input for a kid to tell them what they're doing right. And that might be as simple as great sitting down, great staying still. I'm so glad you're still there. Sometimes I have to look for the simplest things to compliment, but you need to look at it from their perspective of how they might see what's going down around them. And then you can be in your empathy, you can help them make positive changes. The last thought I have is finish with success. So if I'm doing an activity and my client is having a really hard time with it, I want to finish on a successful repetition of the activity. I don't want to finish with them missing the target when they're throwing. Even if I have to give more help or get closer, do whatever I have to do, I want the last time we do anything with that particular activity that it goes well, no matter how much support I have to give for that to happen. And that way the child has left in their mind this memory of something good that happened, not all the frustrations of what happened. So these are all simple ideas on how to think about behavior with clients with autism. And really these things are true for all kids and all adults too, but it really helps my session go better. And some people think that I am really good at working with autistic spectrum kids. So I just thought I would share that information with you so your sessions and your time with your children can go better. I hope this was helpful and I'll look forward to seeing you next time. Thanks, bye. If you liked this video and would like to be notified by email when the next video comes out, click the subscribe button here and click the golden bell icon and ensure notifications are enabled on your account.